everyone. I'm Zaki from the Lab Productions. Our heritage, like our DNA, determines who we are, giving us both identity and values that will guide our lives. Yet, despite its importance, there is never any guarantee that heritage will survive and be passed on to the next generation. Hence, the Pretoria Legacy Foundation have found a way to enhance our heritage by providing opportunities for local people to review, re-engage, and reinterpret their stories. With us today in studio is Crescent Padiachi. He's a BCom graduate. He's a G20 Young Entrepreneurs Alliance ambassador, and he works in the financial industry. Good morning. Thank you so much for joining us, Crescent.
Thank you for having me.
It's only a pleasure. So, tell us, as the young generation of Indian South Africans, do your peers, or do you as a younger generation, consider yourself more Indian or more South African?
Look, I think if you have to take it into consideration, it's both.
Okay.
And it comes with the intent to say we're not more Indian than we are South African.
All right.
But we need to go back to the beginning because we are human.
Okay.
And especially what's happening in the country right now,
mm-hmm.
if you are not human first,
yes,
and you do not define yourself as human first, mm-hmm. the basic values of humanity go out the window.
Mm-hmm.
I am Indian by race, by heritage, and it's something to be proud of,
mm-hmm.
but I am South African as well. But even if we go down from a humanitarian perspective, I am mm-hmm. African first,
yes,
I am South African,
mm-hmm.
and I am Indian.
Okay, there you have it. You summed it up nicely. So let's see how Indian are you, Crescent. What percentage of Indians make up the South African population?
Very little.
That's the youth of today. Okay, very little. Good answer. And what is the Indian culture famous for in South Africa?
Food, number one. I think we have our vibe, our color, brings a lot to the South African context.
Okay.
The way we represent one another from joining the divide, I would
mm-hmm.
say we're not black, we're not white, we
mm-hmm.
slap bang in the middle.
Yes.
And whether we're on either sides of the divide, we are who we are.
Okay, and brown is suddenly a very popular color.
Yeah.
Okay, that was totally off script, and it's just, by the way, pop quiz. So, Crescent, as young Indian South Africans, do you understand the struggles that our forefathers made? And not only talking from your perspective, from the youth in general, how much do they understand and how do they appreciate it?
Yeah, look, I think we need to consider what does understand mean, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because if we look back into the history, we need to look at systems of oppression from the beginning of time.
Mm-hmm.
Specific to South Africa, we're looking at apartheid, but before that it was a survival struggle, and now we're in an economic struggle, and I don't think you can, without considering whatever is happening in South Africa at this point in time, not remember what does a system of oppression do to humanity as a whole.
Yes.
I think understanding where we've come from, we as young people, we stand tall on the shoulders of many people with many struggles that have gone by.
Absolutely.
If we do not recognize that, we do ourselves a disservice. We
mm-hmm.
do ourselves a disservice in the sense that we cannot stand up as people of credibility,
mm-hmm.
Of integrity,
yes.
Without recognizing those struggles.
Yes, absolutely.
And I think there's a big divide. And I think the divide comes in because we have choice. There's a man who told me one day that back in the day,
mm-hmm.
there was 30 cheeses,
yes.
And now there are 300 cheeses.
Mm-hmm.
And we have much more choices, young people, today.
Yes.
And it's the slap bang in the middle again of the culture that we've inherited.
Mm-hmm.
We're very influenced by westernized culture, in South Africa specifically.
Mm-hmm.
But we have the dawn of the digital age,
mm-hmm.
Which is showing that we have much more information than everybody else. And if we really start to look at that choice that's in front of all young people,
mm-hmm.
you start to understand that we might be losing our heritage or we might be gaining our heritage, and
mm-hmm.
and that's very interesting as a platform,
mm-hmm.
because what we want to achieve is never to lose our heritage, because it's some it adds to us.
Yes.
It brings about more vibrance in us. It talks to a single identity.
Yes.
And we never want to lose our identity.
Absolutely.
Because we stand tall on people's
yes.
shoulders.
Do you think these choices that you're talking about right now, do you think with all these choices and the freedom of this choice that you've lost your culture?
It's yes and no. Mm-hmm. It's such a difficult thing to understand for me. I've been griping with it for a very long time.
Okay.
Listening to the stories of people that try and impart knowledge onto you,
mm-hmm.
Versus you going out into the world, into this abundance of data and
yes.
abundance of information and trying to figure out where you are in the world.
Mm-hmm.
There isn't that house that you used to go to where the stories that they tell you
yes.
when you walked out of the house, it was like, sure, but you know, this is like really something.
Yes, feel-good stories.
100%.
Yes.
And we're sitting now where a year story now, and 5 minutes later, it's a different story.
Yes.
And putting my Indian heritage in the middle of that is something that somebody really needs to focus and take the time on
mm-hmm.
nowadays, because you've got social media that's putting an influence there. You've got stories around the world that are making bigger impacts than your heritage, and
mm-hmm.
you need to really focus on your Indian heritage to actually,
So are you, as the younger generation, is that one of your goals in life, or is it just by the way?
Look, that's also another thing, because I'm sitting now where I'm looking at my growth.
Mm-hmm.
And in the context of my growth, I need to see where I am in my life.
Mm-hmm.
I'm finding myself that now, getting a little bit older, you want to know more.
Mm-hmm.
I would have never thought that I would want to travel to India one day.
Yes.
But that's only because I had the opportunity to travel around the world.
Mm-hmm.
Listening to other people's stories, and it's only beckoning in me now that where did my people come from?
Mm-hmm.
What were their struggles? Because it really wasn't as cut and clear as it is right now, where we come into our homes and everything is so nice.
Yes.
And it really was, I mean, looking at the pictures that come out of the heritage,
yes.
Sitting on the ships in the sugar canes, I can only imagine what those people
yes,
were
it was,
going through.
It was a very tough life. Okay, I don't normally do this, but my eye is suddenly catching the badge that you have on your lapel. What is that actually, Krisen?
So it's the Sustainable Development Goals.
Yes.
It's an agenda set out by the United Nations with the deadline of the 2030. And it talks about prosperity, the planet, and looking at economic development in a sustainable way.
Okay.
It looks at eradicating poverty, and also looks at the health systems. It looks at equality in a very big lens that makes it understandable to anybody in the street.
All right.
It has 17 goals.
Mm-hmm.
It was adopted by the 196 nations around the world.
Okay.
It's a framework that allows the common man, companies, governments, a structured framework to reduce the stuff that we see in society. I think the lens is people, planet.
Mm-hmm.
And at the heart of it is how we communicate, converse, do business with one another. And it's within this framework that by the end of 2030,
yes.
we'd like to also reduce our carbon footprint.
Mm-hmm.
That adds to global warming and the pressures that we're seeing in the environment and the economic systems that are out there.
Okay.
So that's
interesting. If you, as the younger generation, with all these choices and freedom and the social media and the data available right now, if you had to rewrite the history of the South African Indians, what would be different?
I think I would really appreciate it if those people and those people that stand tall come to the fore and start telling those stories.
Mm-hmm.
It really makes a big difference in my life and a lot of the youth I know to say, listen, this is really where we come from.
Mm-hmm.
I feel that that's being lost.
Okay.
And I really would like people to part with their knowledge onto us.
Yes.
Because in the big bad world out there, it's not as easy as it looks for mm-hmm. some people. Some people thrive, some people are really struggling.
Yes.
And in those stories of resilience
mm-hmm.
Is what I would really want to change. Those stories really need to come through, like every other race that's doing it right now. They're telling their stories and people are listening.
Yes. So that's what we're doing. That is
yeah.
part of this Legacy Foundation, to bring all those stories and to start to get the youth to mix and to coordinate with the older generation, the forefathers, and hear the stories. So maybe it's not in in for them to write the stories, but you people, yeah, with all these choices and the freedoms and the data and social media that you have, that you can then take it a step further. And like I said, handing the baton over to an even more dynamic generation. Chrisen, your final words. South Africa is in a very, very bad way currently, socially, politically, economically. Taken from the stories that you have heard or learned from your Indian heritage, how can you as the youth make it better?
In the sense of a South African context, we have a president in the country who's standing head and shoulders above the rest.
Okay.
I would love to see more leaders come out of the Indian community.
Mm-hmm.
Guys who are not necessarily wanting the spotlight,
yes,
but do the hard graft.
Yes.
That make the changes every, yes, single day. That take our people from the street and not disable them in the sense of charity,
yes,
but enable them in the sense of,
yes,
information and knowledge.
Yes. Teach a man to fish.
100%.
Yes.
And it's that each one teach one philosophy and the me, we philosophies,
yes,
that run around in the spirit of Ubuntu that we want to see. If we don't start singing and humming and that praises,
mm-hmm,
we kind of lose the narrative.
Okay.
And that's what I want to change. And that's what I want to see young people take the initiative by themselves, because there is no golden spoon anymore.
Yes.
There is nobody coming to help you. You got to do it yourself, but you can only do it within the context of doing it with one another. And that's exactly it.
Okay, well, there you have it. A lovely, refreshing talk with someone from the younger generation, Chrisen Padiachi. And take his advice. The young ones, get in touch with us. We want to hear your version of the our cultural Indian heritage. So get in touch with us, and we year to hear your stories, whether you're young or old. Thank you very much. Thanks, Chrisen, for being with
us.
You're
most welcome. Thank you for having me.
Thank you for generating a greater sense of pride and belonging in our community. Your increased participation does not go unnoticed. To be part of this magical project, please contact us.